I want to talk about this class on voice dysfunctions, tongue tie. I know a lot of you are going to say, I don't see rock stars and singers and artists, or I don't have too many tongue tie in my population. But that's interesting, because I cannot explain so much in the title, but you have many, many cases you probably are going to probably benefit from these techniques. Number one, the general population, when they go to surgery, you need to do an intubation for the general anesthesia. So this intubation is difficult, you need some experience to do it, and you can damage some of the trachea, you can damage some of the tracheal cartilage, and you can feel on your patient the cartilage are side-bending, shearing, rotating. Now what happened is, few years later, your patient, your clients may have some problem with deglutition, with talking, but maybe they have some chronic infection in winter, pharyngitis, laryngitis, they can't express themselves, their posture may change. Many changes happen many years later and nobody remember the surgery. What happened also is, if you have people that play, strangle themselves for martial arts or domestic violence, this area is very sensitive and you may have to release this larynx, this voice box. It's very important. When you do a release there, it's very, very global in the body often. You have to understand the larynx and the tongue, for example, is connected to the rest of the body, to the cranium. The tongue have the styloglossus muscle, for example, all the way to the rest of the body through the larynx. You have the trachea, the bronchi, the lungs, the heart, the diaphragm. Through the esophagus, you're going to have the stomach and the intestine. So everything up and down, superior and inferior, are going to be connected with the tongue. The problem with the tongue is, tongue tie is difficult to diagnose. There's not a strong protocol, there's not an accepted assessment. And there's different type of tongue tie. Sometimes it's anterior tongue tie, sometimes it's posterior, difficult to see. So I'm going to show you some assessment, not to diagnose, unless you are a physician. It's just to help you assess for manual therapy and to treat. So those assessments will help you, give you an idea about the situation with the tongue. The release are sometimes spectacular. When you release tongue tie, people are going to say, wow, my posture is so different. My shoulder could never be released before by any treatment. My neck, and that is going to be released by the tongue tie. Sometimes the shoulder are going to release, the elbow, the wrist are going to release. They're going to breathe better. Their face is going to open, the cheekbone are going to go higher. They're going to be able to talk, express themselves, eat better, swallow better. There's a lot of changes that happen that you have to know how to assess and treat. And so you have to see tongue tie. The problem is, health professionals are often not well trained to diagnose tongue tie, lip tie on a kid, on a baby. And we are going to show you how to do that. How often you have someone with headaches and you think about tongue tie? Chronic headaches every morning, sleep disorder, apnea. If your tongue is tied, you cannot press on your palate, you cannot open your mouth, and you can have apnea, obstructive apnea, sleeping disorders. You can have bruxism at night, you clench your teeth, you could have eating disorders. You have many things that are often not taught so much. The diagnostic is difficult. You have probably a very large part of the population with some type of tongue tie. Officially, we have about 5% of kids with tongue tie. Now, recently, we maybe have 11%, but I think there's many more people affected with tongue tie. It's like underestimated. It's like a hidden area that we don't work. That's why I do this class. You're going to work with the higher weight, with the different part of the larynx, the epiglottis, the thyroid cartilage, the cricoid, the trachea, the esophagus, the constrictor muscles, and different part of the esophagus, thoracic, abdominal, cervical. And hope you will enjoy. Thank you.